Hold up, wait up. You can't stop this here. You can't top this tear. Work too hard, my God. I'ma play my card. I'ma leave your atmosphere. It's so toxic. And I hear your gossip. I'm aware they plotting. But I got no option. And I can't be stopped. I'ma keep on walking. And my power and my purpose. And that backbiting so worthless. And my faith on and it's working. I'm one of one and I'm certain that I won the battle. It's over. We did it. I'm still. I'm C. I'm P. No limit. Can't stop it. It's me and Corbin in the pocket. Got the plug in the socket.
They told you that you couldn't do it cause you washed up. Ain't like them bad girls that you should get your sauce up. But I got this plan and you might not understand.
Come on in, everybody. Welcome to Transparent Thursday.
Just watch me do this, put no limits, only swag on it. Walk right up to the front.
It is time for us to have the conversation.
Walk to the top, I'ma give it all I got. Might take a lot, but we ain't gonna ever stop.
Of Tonya'z Embrace LLC, where we specialize in transferring people from their hurting place to their healing space. Welcome to Transparent Thursday. I thank you so much for your time. This is our 13th conversation. So we started this journey together on May the 7th, and I want to just thank you again for tuning in. Tonight, we're going to talk about something. I don't know if you guys remember, but I sent out a post saying, give me some topics that you would like to speak from. And this was the number one topic. This was the number one topic, family secrets. And I'm going to go ahead and say this. This is Transparent Thursday, so that means we're going to have the honest conversation. We are going to jump in. We're not going to sugarcoat anything. We're going to have the conversation. So tonight, our topic is family secrets when blood ain't thicker than water. The proper word, of course, isn't, but we are going to say the word ain't because that's how I feel about it. When blood ain't thicker than water. So, as you know, we start out with definitions. What is a family? It's a group of two or more people who are related by either birth, marriage, or adoption. Matter of fact, the family and the home is the foundational institution that was ordained by God Himself. So it's the first institution. Family, of course, again, is related by either marriage or adoptions. Okay, what is a secret? A secret is something kept hidden or unexplained. Something kept from the knowledge of others. Some synonyms for secret are concealing, hiding, withholding, camouflaging, and suppressing. Y'all know how I feel about all those words if you're a regular Transparent Thursday listener. Okay, here is the number one fact. I'm going pretty fast because we have a lot to cover. And I pray, you guys know, if you have any questions or comments, I do have someone monitoring those. So please feel free at any time to ask any question. This is Transparent Thursday. This is where you are safe. And we're going to have the conversation very openly and honestly, very authentic, real, raw, and relevant. So please don't be hesitant about asking your questions. We're on this journey together. We're all a part of a family. So we all probably have experienced this particular thing. The fact is, one of the most toxic problems confronting families is the existence of secrets. Fact. Not a myth. Fact is, one of the most toxic problems confronting families is the existence of secrets. Because secrets prevent open communication and ultimately lead to serious health and mental problems for family members. All right. In the end, some families are unable to maintain their cohesiveness because of family secrets. Now, one thing about, we know that nothing is new under the sun. Family secrets have been around since the beginning of time. If you remember, there was two brothers that actually had got into a little altercation, and one is named Cain, and one is named Abel, and they actually had a dispute. And when they talked about what the secret, well, let me tell you what Abel said. But Cain got an attitude. He said, "And if I were to kill thee, who is there to demand thy blood for me?" And he said, "God brought us into this world. He will avenge me. He will require my blood at thy hand." So if y'all remember how the blood of Abel actually spoke out, because what was Cain trying to do? He was trying to cover. He thought nobody saw. So this secret thing is nothing new. Why do you think, and please put in the chat, why do you think families keep secrets? What do you think they make that decision to keep secrets? One of the most common reasons people justify keeping secrets is to protect someone. So I know we have experienced that. One of the most common reasons is that people justify keeping a secret to protect someone. Secret also originate from fears that actions. It prevents, when you keep a secret, this is what the thought is. It prevents embarrassment. It protects a family from judgment and avoid any punishments. These secrets often lead to internal trust issues increased by anxiety and shame. Secrets undermine the connections members of a family are supposed to have for one another. Insidious secrets such as sexual abuse in a family or extramarital affairs pulls at the very fabric of a family that and are rooted in shame and broken rules and taboo subjects. Now, in our culture alone, we have heard, I know y'all probably can quote it with me, what goes on in the house stays on in the house. What people don't know won't hurt them. That is a lie. Not a fact, that is a lie. Okay, there are three types of, and I'm going through stuff now as a life coach certification to let you know some of the things that happens when people keep secrets. All right, there are three types of family secrets. There's an individual secret, eternal family secret, then shared family secrets. The ones that we really get in odds about the most is the shared family secrets. That means you might have two members might know something, but if they're keeping it from the other person, but the so they consider themselves a group, and then you have another group over here who's unlearned, don't have the knowledge, and they can't figure out what's going on, but they know something is different. All right, some of the consequences of a family secret. Okay, every family, so let's get a difference because some people are like, well, there's some good secrets. All right. Now, every family has a right to privacy, i.e., such as hiding some birthday present, having a surprise birthday party. If someone is sick and there's a private diagnosis, of course, that's something you might want to keep in the family. However, secrecies that center on rule violations and taboo subjects create strife in the family. Secrets of this nature lead to isolation, anxiety about the secret emerging, and a shared family secret. Everybody's got to figure out where their loyalty lies. So if you have a family who is a whole unit, now once the secret in, and not to say for instance me and my sister know, then I'm gonna have to figure out what loyalty I'm going to have either to the other members of the family, or I'm going to have it to my sister. Right, so that automatically creates a divide within the family, right? So there's no sense of connection. So if you have five members of a family, two people over here know something, it automatically, this is what I want y'all to know about secrets, people, in a family that are shared, it automatically pull at the fabric of what family is supposed to be about. It automatically makes someone feel like I have to be loyal over here and disloyal or betray the other part, but we all supposed to be family. So that's why it's so dangerous to keep secrets within a family. Sorry, y'all. We just heard somebody squish and we thought somebody got an accident. So sorry for that pause. Okay. When a family secret is an ongoing condition, both family relationships and interactions with the outside world are profoundly affected. If there's a secret ongoing, it actually affects the condition of the house, and it also affects the condition of the people that are outside. What do we mean by that? Members become paralyzed and unable, which is a big key. I'm so excited about this subject, y'all, as y'all probably can tell, because secrets really destroy, okay? Members become paralyzed, unable to develop relationships with others, and it deepens the family divide. So just because, and we have seen this, just the fact that you're covering a secret within your family, when you step out, you have a problem developing honest, true, and trustful relationships. Here are some things that secrets do. Secrets are problematic, okay? Secrets destroy relationships. Secrets affect children's lives. Secrets cause suspicion and resentment. Secrets create a false sense of reality. And a big clincher that most people don't think about, secrets also cause illness. Secrets make you sick. Secrets create a bad energy while attempting to keep information from others. You focus on your energy and you put it in the wrong place. So where you supposed to be loving, where you supposed to be open, where you supposed to be naked, where you supposed to be vulnerable, you got so much, your energy is spent more over there trying to keep a secret than having a relationship with the people that God has presented in a family. You are not authentic when secrets are created. It is not authentic at all. The mindset, like I said before, what they don't know won't hurt them is the furthest thing from the truth. Secrets are bad for your health and your brain. Secrets are bad. I have said it again because people think when you keep secret, if you're covering it good, that it doesn't affect your physical body. It affects your health. And it affects your brain. Secrets, especially those that are big, they take a lot of our energy to keep it hidden. It'll make you sick. Secrets make you lonely. Secrets create disrespect. Secrets are stressful. When you're supposed to be lightweight and having a good time, but you got a secret, you can't enjoy life like you're supposed to. So this is why you don't want to keep secrets. Now, under secrets are these things we call lies, right? Lies are normally, because what you're covering is what you're not being truthful. You're not being authentic. So in that self, you are telling a lie because you're not being your authentic self. Study shows that participants who cut back on lying have fewer mental health problems, and they can they are not anxious or anything. But when you're lying and keeping secrets, you are more prone to be anxious, depressed, your triggers headaches, and causes nausea. I can be a witness to that. Sick all the time. Couldn't figure out. And a lot of the stuff we having, people, and I'm go ahead and say it. This is Transparent Thursday. A lot of the sickness we having is because we are suppressing secrets. Our bodies were not made to do that. So it's going to show up somewhere else. It is not giving its proper function because you're keeping secrets. So that's why secrets are not good, especially in a family. Now let me tell you about families, and that was all the good technical stuff about how it affects you. Now I just want you to be honest, think about your life, think about your family, and think about what happens when especially a child has to keep a secret. So we're gonna go through some real life scenarios that I know that I've been through, that some of my friends have been through. So we're finna talk about it. Now, let me tell you something about what's so unfair about family secrets is because when the adults are placing pressure on the children to keep a secret, the children are doing their brain development. And y'all know this already. If you've been on Transparent Thursday, from 0 to 6, your brain is moving rapidly. Your brain does not stop developing, people, until you're like 25 years old. So all the time when you think you're 18, you are not an adult because your brain is still, there is still some functioning things you do not understand. And it is unfair. It is wrong. It is disingenuous to have a child keep a secret because there, as my friend Wesley Big Priest said today, a child's shoulders were not built to bear the weight of their parents' secrets. And let me tell y'all something about secrets. There is no reason to really keep a secret. Everybody was like, well, and we're not, like I said, we're not talking about if we having a surprise party for something. We are talking about the secrets that have harmful effects. That is going to actually change the trajectory of someone's life because you are keeping that secret. Deciding, this is the thing about everything that we do. Deciding to keep a secret or tell a lie is always a choice. It's all these people, well, I couldn't, and I, no, you made a choice to keep the secret. Choice, decision, decided. So here we go. I'm just gonna give you a scenario. All right, you have members of a family, and you have all the children around, let's say 13, 15, and 11. Okay, 11, 13, 15. And there is a secret that one of the parents tell the child. The child love what? Both of their parents. This parent, this secret, the family unit, it would just destroy everything about what family means. But some big head parent made a decision to keep a secret, and they gave it to one of their children, right? So what does the child have to decide? I love this parent and I love this parent. So there is a loyalty to one, a betrayal of others, and I can't say anything to the other siblings in the family. That particular pressure is wrong. And what happens is it automatically makes that person not be authentic. You do not give that job to a child. When you cannot be 100% authentic, you are teaching them how to lie. You are teaching them not how to be real. You are teaching them all the a parent is not supposed to teach their child that. Then you create a divide, because if those two sisters were close, or that, or their brother and their sister was close, now she can't even tell that to the sibling. Now you create a divide with them. So why aren't we and my, what's going on between me and my sister? What's wrong with her? She's carrying something that is too heavy to bear. And parents do that all the time. It could be an extramarital affair. It could be that they want to get a divorce, or they doing something for one parent that they can't, they know that another parent would not agree with. So now this person who's a child that's still in development has to live a lie, keep a secret, cannot be 100%. And then, and I'm going to tell you what's also bad. And then when you step outside of that home, you step outside of that circle, you have to be in, you have to be fake, unreal with people that you come in contact with. I don't care if it is church. I don't care if it's school. I don't care if it's just your friends down the street. You are not equipped as children to keep family secrets. Let's go to another scenario that I know. All right. We have someone who's in a family. They go, they know that this is their family. They get ready to go to college. And before they go to college, the family decides to have a meeting. So they thinking, hey, this all about me going away. We getting together one last time. And someone says, before we go, there's something we have to tell you. This man right here that raised you is not your father. So what do you think that's going to do for someone who is an adult now, well, on their way to college, being successful, know who they are, so they thought, all these connections they have made, and y'all decide at this moment, this is the time. And so that means I can't trust you. I can't trust you. And all y'all knew, ain't nobody told me nothing. Hey, I'm 18 years old. I'm finna go to college making my way. Then they start questioning who they are. Those are secrets that we should not keep, people. There is a time when you tell a child, I'm adopted. Okay? So I know there is a time, but it ain't 18. Because when that person is getting their identity, you have to deal with that in the right time for them. There is no time to tell somebody when they're on their way out to this world, because now they know they can't trust you. How you think they're going to build relationships? Everything they have built has been a faulty foundation. Every single thing. Everything they know about themselves. And the thing is, most people that I know that go through this, there was a time when they asked. They was like, something is different about me. And lucky for me, when I started talking about it, I knew. So I was able to understand heredity. I was able to understand the love from my stepfather. I was able to understand all of that. And I was like blessed, because I had three families of love. You know what I'm saying? So, but when you wait till someone is already developed, knowing they're on their way, got their goals, got their dreams, and then you give like that, that's not good. Let's go further back into our black culture. What about the woman who got pregnant at 15? And back in the day, you take the her and that child away and hide them till they have the baby, take their baby, bring them back home, and like nothing ever happened. Mm. Never questioning what is this going to do for somebody who's actually birthed a child and they don't know where their child is. Never question that. Now, because everything, and I'll tell you what, since I'm a PK and not been in church forever, most secrets of this kind of nature is all about image. Protection. We don't want to look this way. My child getting pregnant out of wedlock and I'm the preacher? Oh, I can't have that. Because I can't. No child that God has purpose here is a mistake. I come from a situation where I came out of wedlock. But just because God created me, I have purpose. So that's for every single child. So those are things we did back in our culture where, and then the person come back and people be like, where you been? And then they told the lie. And then your grandparents and your parents tell you what story to give everybody when you get in the street. Those secrets destroy people. They destroy. I got so many, here's another secret. How many friends do I have that have babies by preachers? They getting paid. They got a place to stay. But you're burying this child alive. So when that child asks about where his daddy, y'all got to make up some story about who their father is. And a lot of times the father is right there. You just can't tell nobody. I experienced that. What do you think that does to the development and the security of anybody? Secrets destroy. They create divide. Then it actually don't, you don't know who you are. One of the reasons why, and I get personal, so all those stories with, you know, different people. One of the reasons why I, to this day, I have development issues. Because a lot of times I'm learning how to trust even now. Because coming out the gate, I was told, lie, praise. This is what we come to show. Don't say nothing nobody. Don't do this. Oh, go to church, raise your hand, shout, sing, smile. And then I like, but that ain't my life. All to keep something in this pretty bowl. And the thing about it, it is like you get so conflicted as a child. You're trying to love God. You're trying to even know who he even is. And the very people that are supposed to represent him telling you to lie. Then you can read clearly in the Bible some of the things that we're not supposed to do. So I had very terrible guy relationships growing up. Y'all know about my molestations. Y'all know all about that. Rape. Y'all know all. I am just getting to a point where I can meet a guy. And not saying because on a sexual way, just a guy, just because he is a male, and just say, look at them at face value without saying they what they want from me. Or I don't trust because he's a guy. Because all my life, all the things that I was told was right, was wrong. Then I can't tell about it. Then I'm like, oh, this happened to me. Then I got my own development issues. I don't know what's real, what's fake. Well, I don't know anything. And all of these, most of the time, were men of God. So I'm just confused. So now, like I see Robert is on, Robert Harrison. Immediately when I met him, I felt his spirit. This wasn't about no sex. This wasn't about nobody trying to get nothing from nobody. He is one of the few people I have met in the last 2 years instantaneously attract for a right reason. Just say, I trust him. I love the way he's talking. I feel the spirit. But do you not know? You can ask my husband. That is a struggle for me all the time if I'm not careful. Why can't I develop healthy men relationships? Because I had to keep secrets. Unfair. Not right. And you telling me to keep a secret in the name of Jesus. I have been, let me tell you how in disingenuous I have been to myself. I have grown up, got molested by people, have to go to their congregation, have to sing. And when they're preaching, I get up and clap like I'm applauding them. Knowing that this situation was terrible. And I got to smile in front of everybody. Because I don't want to hurt the wife. I don't want the kids to find out. I don't want nobody else to find out. So I got to do something to tear myself down and pretend, but I've been doing this all my life. And I'm going to tell y'all a situation. I told y'all this is going to be transparent. This is true. I have lost my virginity from the man, went to his church and performed, kept his kids. I've done all of that. Get married to my second husband, and he remained a relationship with my father. I didn't know. I just figured like, that's going to be a broken relationship. I was not prepared. I ain't got to see the person no more. I'm good. I am 30-something years old, sitting in my dad's congregation. And for those who are going to go back and tell my dad, we've already talked about this. So this is old stuff. But I'm sitting in church worshiping with my husband at the time, enjoying worship. And my daddy walks up the aisle with the person that took my virginity because their friendship remained. I'm married. over 30 years old, and I start having convulsions, and they had to pull me out of church and take my blood pressure, or Tonya's hyperventilating, and all this stuff, all because somebody walked in, and I felt like he don't deserve to be here. What you mean you're going to maintain a relationship with them in the name of Jesus? And then I didn't know they was coming, because of course y'all know me. I don't show up where I'm going to be uncomfortable. So I had to go through that, and I thought about all the times that I had to keep the secret, had to applaud, had to cheer on somebody who took my innocence away. So my relationship with men, church, people, what I even thought a family was supposed to be, because I'm thinking family is protection, covering, all that stuff, and I was wrong. Because there's another thing that was more important at that time than me. That's the truth. So I just turned 51 Saturday. I am still in the process of developing relationships, and not only with men, with women, because a lot of times the women did the covering in church. Everybody know, but we ain't gonna say nothing. And it's not a physical family, but it is the family of God. And I'm gonna tell y'all something later. I'm trying to see if I have any questions in the time soon, so I can make a pause. Okay. What I'm trying to tell y'all about secrets, they destroy. There are things that right now at 51 years old I have to think about, because there's a part of my brain that didn't develop when it was supposed to. And this is things we have in psychology called frozen. You actually frozen in a development stage because of a secret, because of a trauma, and you can't tell about it. And so to be disingenuous, go out there and smile, I like you not hurting, don't deal with nothing, and y'all think that's not going to show up nowhere? That you think that's not going to show up anywhere? Yes, it will. Why am I addicted to sex? Secrets. Why was I addicted to drugs? And I don't say was. If you're addicted to anything, you're going to forever be addicted, right? So there are things that's why I don't go certain places, do certain things, because I know it's going to easily draw me back into it. Why was I addicted to drugs? Why was I addicted to partying? Was I addicted to alcohol? Sex. Y'all don't hurt me. The only time I felt good was I was on my back. Why was I doing that? Because I was told I was never, nobody came in, said, oh, let's take care of this, but you were told me to keep a secret. Does that spill out to my other relationships? Of course, I'm on my third marriage, people. And I still struggle, if I'm totally honest, with trying to have a healthy relationship with my husband. Not his fault, but all this stems from early lies, early secrets. You can't tell nobody, so I'm not even developing healthy relationship. And if you can't trust the people in your house, you sure ain't finna go out here and try to trust nobody else. Unfair.
Robert said he counteracts us. That's gross.
Okay, write that down for me so I can see it. I'm telling you, people, and it is wrong. It is wrong to make a child, especially, or a family member, keep a secret. I have another friend. Her kids got molested by somebody, but that person was a family member. You can't tell. All this stuff happened all the time. And then you're trying to figure out why your kids can't function, why they can't talk, why they can't have relationships, why they, all this time people talking about, most introverts, yeah, it is a true thing being introvert. People don't like people. They feel safe by themselves. Why? Because when they was in your care, the person that was supposed to keep them safe, you didn't make them safe. They don't know how to interact with anybody. Oh, she just shy. She just slow. She didn't know. She been covering. And it's going to show up somewhere. You might not be crazy like me and be all in the streets and homeless and doing all kind of crazy things that I was doing. Lord, and only by the grace of God that I'm here today. But it's going to show up. It's going to show up in their personality. It's going to show up somewhere. How they even develop. And some of these kids ain't slow at school. They keeping secrets. And if you're somebody that's older like me, what secrets have you kept? And you tell me how has it made you affect your life. It's never positive. when you keep these types of taboo subjects secret. It goes into the very fabric of who you are. What's supposed to be so easy is family relationships. Becomes hard. It becomes work. It becomes hard. And we are being so unsuccessful with just relationships because that started at home. Now, let me tell y'all something. Do I have any questions? You say no questions. All right. Is that good? Nobody got no questions? All right. Okay. My brother Robert Harrison said, it counteracts and stunts growth when you keep secrets. Maria Ewan said, every child needs to know who they are. Secrets and lies cultivate deep insecurities. Amen, amen, and amen. Some of the stuff wrong with y'all kids, and I tell you, you ain't got no kids. I've been one. I know why I felt insecure, why I felt worthless, why I felt like I ain't have no value. Secrets, lies, and then it's under the umbrella of God himself. And that is not God, people. I am tired of seeing kids, especially teenagers, why they acting like this? And everybody talking, but ain't nobody trying to get to the core of what's wrong with them. Why did a child sleep with somebody? She just 15. She fast and grown. Why? Looking for love because you ain't do your job? That goes for house. That goes for church. These are institutions God himself ordained. For covering, for protection, and everybody messed up. How many? I got one of my friends from Florida, grew up with me. We've been friends forever. How many of our friends are on drugs? How many of our friends are dead? How many, like I said before, how many of my friends got kids by pastors and leaderships and they can't tell nobody? This child don't even know where he belong. And then y'all want him to get in society and be successful? When you could have just being open and stop keeping secrets? It blows my mind how y'all want somebody to be developed, but you didn't take the time to develop them. What kind of sense does that make? How you gonna pass a test when the teacher didn't get structure on how to do it? And you push these kids out here in the world. I'm talking about me too. I'm just an older kid. I got out here, I didn't know nothing. Didn't know how to function whatsoever. Until I kept getting knocked down. What am I doing as a preacher's kid that's grown up with, we ain't weren't rich, but I've always had something to eat. What I'm doing homeless? What I'm doing looking for, some man can just treat me in kind of way and it's okay. Why can't I have good, healthy relationships with anybody? Starts at the house, people. Secrets, and stop telling your children to shh and don't tell nobody, because they're going to tell one way or the other, because suppression never works. And all this mental health stuff we got going on now is a lot of times because people, it affects your psychological growth, your development, your health. And some of the people that sick ain't really sick, they just been keeping secrets, so they'd rather go get high, they'd rather go do something else so they won't have to deal. Now you're giving them pills because they can't deal. All because we could have been taken away because we just need not keep secrets. And I know it seems like I'm mad at people. I'm not mad. I'm just excited. I'm reading the question, everybody. Okay. I have a question. It says, how did you go about working to deal with those secrets and start the healing process? What I did at first, my very first thing, because I'm be honest with you, I tried to work it out myself. I tried to pray. I tried to shout. If it was a ministry at my dad's church, I'm going to try to be on it. I was in 3 different singing groups. I was doing writing for the church newsletter. I'm doing everything, and it was not working. And I'm like, God, you mean I'm doing all this work for you, and I'm still feeling like this? So what I had to do, finally, and I think y'all heard me say this before, finally. Because let me tell you something about secrets too. I didn't even realize that it was affecting my relationships in the people that I thought I loved or in the people that I thought that loved me. But you can all, y'all know how that thing feel when you got an elephant in the room, even in your house. But this is church world. This is image world. This is, and I'm feeling like, hey, we ain't going to talk about this. I was that kid. Y'all know, I'm going back to your question. To me, this is where I am right now. Every Thanksgiving, every Christmas, whatever y'all do, when you get your little family together, I'm this person here. There's a rug in the room, and there's a whole bunch of crap under this rug, which causes a hump, right? People walk in the house, trip over the hump, and get up like ain't nothing happened. I'm the person like, can't we just pull back the rug, get the stuff up so we all can be okay? Why we gotta keep bumping our head? That makes no sense to me. But when you're that person and everybody else somewhere else, it makes a divide. So I understand very clearly why some things happen now. So what I did, the person that asked me this question, once I got to a place where I literally felt like I was about to lose it, because I felt like everything that I was taught, I done lied, I done covered, I done did church, I done talk, I've done song for you, Jesus, dance for you, Jesus, shouted for you, Jesus. I done did all that, and I still not good. So I said, let me do this. Let me go get me some help. I was at a job that gave us free mental, like you can go see somebody. I said, I'm finna go to therapy because I need to figure out why I am wired this way. Why do I feel unworthy? And I don't mean because you'll never be worthy enough for Jesus, but I was so worthless. I just couldn't, I ain't good. I was calling myself ugly, fat. This is the biggest I've been right now. And it's like, I was a size 3, and I was like, I'm fat, I'm ugly, ain't nobody gonna want me. Every time I have a relationship, and I just got tired of it. And then I wasn't having no good, close relationships with the family. Like, I was like, why we not connecting? So this is what I did. Okay, Tonya, you gonna go see somebody? You got these little free things right here, or you got this on your insurance? You go see somebody. And I did that. And when I say it was one of the hardest things and hardest of choices I had to make, but it was the best choice, because when you got so many, I don't know if y'all saw the picture where you got wires all over the place and the therapist is someone who actually can hear all your information and make all this stuff come out smooth. That's what he did for me. So, and this is what was so good about it, because I didn't even choose a woman therapist. I chose a male therapist. And when that man, and I'm telling you what really changed, that really hit home for me, when that man, after hearing my story, and say, there's nothing wrong with you, we can work this out, but let me tell you what I want you to really know. You are not your body. A man told me that. What you mean? My body's all I had. I've been sacrificing my body since I was 6 years old. What you mean? I'm not my body. I'm going to teach you that your womanhood is not just only defined by you giving somebody something. This is a man telling me. So did you, and I know it was God, because a man had to tell me. It wouldn't have sounded as sweet and good if I had a woman tell me that, because all the men had already been destroying me. So I needed a man, a healthy man, to come back around and say, you are not your body. We're going to work this out. And it was hard. And I had homework. And I was like, I don't want to go there. Tonya, you got to go there. I don't want to say that. You got to say that, Tonya, because whatever you don't confront, and whatever you don't acknowledge, it will not change. So that's what I did. And that's how I started the healing process. So once I started doing the healing process, I continued. I didn't get my little sessions and say, oh, I'm good. No, because I had, 28 years of hell. It wasn't going to be done in those 6 sessions. So I had to stop paying for sessions because my insurance ain't covering. But was it worth it? Yes. I chose me. I'm like, oh, we can choose, Tonya. And to this day, that therapist is still in my life. Till this day. And when I say he's proud, and he's like, girl, you all right with me. I knew it was going to work out. And God changed all this stuff around for you. Yes, it did. But that's where I started. And I had to go back to those very people. The person that took my virginity and raped me and all this stuff, I wrote a letter, because he taught me in therapy that I don't have to confront no means I actually got to be in somebody's face. You write your feelings out, send the person, because they release you from it. You forgive. You do this. And I did that. Sent that letter. Not just the people that hurt me, the people that I hurt, I had to go back and apologize. There are women that I help apologize for sleeping with their husbands. That was part of my therapy. If you was in my way, and I... I did that. Was that hard? Yes, because I could have been, somebody could have beat me up. I don't know what was going to happen. But I had to get it right. So that's the things. And I, to this day, if I feel like this whole, and I'll be honest with y'all, this COVID-19 thing, since I'm an extrovert, me not hugging people and being around people plays, is like, I'm lonely up in here. What? Then I lose my job. Are you kidding me? Not talking to nobody all day? And I had to still go back to those tools about me being healthy. Reach out. When I said reach out to your strong friend, I was reaching out, and I thank God some people's reaching out to me. Because it has been hard. So I tell everybody now, if I have to go back on the couch, even as a licensed life coach, I will go back on the couch. And that's why I'm always saying I'm in the process of recovery. When I learn something new, I apply it. If it works for me, it helps me. And if you see my shirt, somebody just gave me a comment. It says, talking is healing. My shirt says, silence prevents healing. I believe, and that's why I think about secrets. You telling people to be quiet and you want them to carry all this weight, that's not fair. Another comment I got, therapy saves lives. Someone else said, when this happened, you're the elephant in the room when everyone in the family knows the truth about you, but you. Yes, that's a hard thing. And it's funny sometimes when I show up, I'm real true for real. It makes everybody uncomfortable because everybody know I'm not going to deal with these secrets. If it's going to, and I'm going to tell y'all something. If it's harmful to, especially a child and their development and how they're going to live their life, if I know about it, we're going to take care of it. I don't even think about it because they deserve to live the best life ever. If you mess up your life or things happen to you, all right, and you getting together, great. But children are being molded. And when I say children, that means you could be 22 and I still consider you a child because your brain ain't developed. If I found out that somebody is mistreating you, or you got to keep a secret for because your granddaddy did this, your nasty uncle, or your auntie, or whatever, church or no church, if I find out, we taking care of it. Because it's not fair. Because that person, it actually changes who they are. They do not develop, and they do not be what, I mean, they, it just stunts their growth, and it's not fair. What time is it? 7:47. Okay. Like I said, people, I'm really not angry, but I love people so much because it's enough going on. We got COVID, we got racism, and my family is supposed to be the unit of covering, protection. And then we call this thing the family of God. Then you get there, that's supposed to be covering and protection. And let me tell y'all something. I kind of being disingenuous with this title. All right. The reason why I kept the title where it was is because that's what everybody wanted. That was the number one subject. But if you ever look up the real original meaning of, and I'm going to free some people up because this freed me up. I hope it frees you up. The original meaning of blood is thicker than water was not about your relatives, because there's a difference between being a relative and being family. So the original meaning was about a person coming into covenant with another person. So, well, who was friends and about? Saul and David, right? They actually at that time got the blood, so they became blood brothers, right? So the truth of the matter, the water, this is what tripped me out when I found this out, you guys. I did not know this. The water part of that statement is talking about your relatives because you shared a womb. That's the water. The covenant that you share with people is actually what's thicker than the womb. So I've been talking to my dad about this, not lately, but this early. I'm like, Daddy, why are you comfortable with them? You call them brothers, but you got some real brothers over here. Why that relationship is better? When I talk about my friends, and I'm gonna be transparent, my development with relationship with my blood sister, natural from the womb sister, is not the same I have with my friends. And so I call them sister. How does that happen? Because family is something that you can actually choose. Relationship is a whole nother thing. Relative just means you share the same talking about something that's thick, blood is thicker than water. They're talking about the blood of a covenant, of agreement. Someone that decided that I'm choosing you to take care of. That freed me up. Because a lot of times you think it's just because somebody is related to you, shared the womb with you, then that automatically decides that's going to be a bond, and that's not true. People have their own thoughts, their own, and then the thing about two people dealing with their own stuff, because family secrets are what they are. I'm sure that I have some, even much as I'm being transparent, there's some secrets I still haven't shared with my family. They don't know. So my disconnecting from them and certain things has nothing to do with them. So like, I'm not saying that because these other secrets weren't taken care of, so I'm not doing that. So it brings a divide. But there are some people that I can be unfiltered with, right? I was talking about this yesterday, unfiltered, this Tonya. And they are in covenant with me. So when the next time when you don't get, and I know people, when people is giving me the subject, because we just expect, because that's what we've been told all our life. Blood supposed to be thick in the water. Why my sister liking like this? Why my mama doing this? That's not the thickness. The thickness is the people that you choose to cover you, and you cover. Why? I mean, and I hate to talk about it, but gangs. Why are gangs so important? They consider themselves family. Because one thing they know about each other, I got your back, and you got mine. Mm-hmm. So this whole idea that we grew up with, the saying, blood is thicker than water, it's not talking about your relatives. It's talking about the people that you choose to be family. Mm-hmm. Relationship, relative, is actually the water because you shared the womb. So for me, I can still have a great relationship with my family. And I can have, but I mean, my relatives. And then I can have a great relationship with my family. It's to me, it freed me up. It just blessed me, because a lot of times we spend time forcing relationships, thinking something's supposed to be a certain way. You just because you my sister, you supposed to do this. And that's not true, people. When I tell y'all, I did not know this for a long time. And now when I saw the subject come through, I actually said, and it kept coming, because people like expect. I mean, and I'm not saying you shouldn't. I love when people have their relatives or their family. I love seeing that. I love it. I love it. I applaud that if that's possible. But if you have this the secrets in the family and there's a disconnect and this person might have a total idea, then this person, I believe you can be disagree on the subject and not be disagreeable. So I have a lot of subjects. Like me and my dad, we talk. When we do talk, there's something that we ain't gonna never see eye to eye, but I ain't finna fall out about it. He ain't finna fall out about it. So we can have a relationship in that form, but when I talk about the covenant, the togetherness, the cohesiveness, the spirit to spirit stuff, a lot of times it's not my friends who I don't even call them friends, I call them sisters. Because we have chosen, we have made a covenant with one another. And when you come into the body of Christ, you are making a covenant. And that's why it hurts so bad when y'all talk about, well, I don't want church. It is true, because when you come under the covenant of the blood of Christ, and then you get mistreated, and you supposed to be my family? Yeah, it hurts. And then, I'm supposed to go out here in this big old world and live how? Come on. All right, I think I got some more. What do I have? Oh, I'm going to do that last. Okay. One question for me is how was I treated by my abuser after I addressed them? I'm like, which one? It's been a lot of them. but one in particular. Let me see. I want to see. Honest with you, a lot of them are cowards. I've actually walked up and told people, like, I was a child and you took advantage of me and everything. And I did have one to say they were sorry, but they didn't treat me good. It was more like avoidance. It was more about them keeping an image. Come over here, let's talk over here. You know, it's all this secrecy again. And I'm like, I'm a grown woman. And we're grown. Let's have a conversation. So to me, it's been a lot of rejection. And the rejection normally comes from the people, not so much the ones that did the abuse, but their friends and family and all that stuff. Because, oh, Tonya talking now. So everybody's in fear. And so a lot of people, just rejection most of the time. I have not, be honest with you, I have not had someone deny. Like if I'm talking to them one-on-one. Now, there are some times when you're in the public and somebody, did you? Oh, no, I ain't do that. I know they lying. They know they lying. But one-on-one, most every time that I have confronted someone, even though they ain't gonna be close to me, of course they feel they're gonna give me some rejection, but they didn't deny. So that actually helped me, because when people always calling you crazy and stuff, and you know you ain't crazy, you know what you've been through, it's for somebody to acknowledge that they actually hurt you. So I don't have, but what I don't have is relationships with those people. Zero relationship. Like, that's what I was talking about on my other live about, does forgiveness mean reconciliation? We have nothing. Don't send me no Facebook requests. I'm going to block you every time. I've got that 100 times. I'm not doing, we're not going to dinner. We're not doing it. Oh, Tonya, you grown now? I can't. No, we ain't got none of that, because I can't. I'd rather just forgive you, go on. I wish you no harm. Go ahead, preach, brother, preach. But we're not doing that. So they treated me, rejection. It was like, off, like they scared and they run. But like I said, there was no denial. But not bad. I can't say. There was just one person that tried to make you, look bad and everything. But of course, he got found out. So, which is all back to image. So they treated me okay. But I don't really care about their treatment. This other question say, how do you handle those who are opposing forces of your truth? That's a good question. At first, I talk about how I did it first. At first, I was hurt because I felt like, one thing about truth is always going to be truth. So if we're all under the spirit of the truth, making something free, or it needs to be out there, because when you got truth, you can deal with it. I was very hurt at first when people made me the bad guy. I mean, there are people that threaten my life. There are people wanting to fight me and everything. And I'm like, but I'm telling the truth. And so I lost so many people because of truth. Because those are things we're not going to talk about. Everybody knows what's going on, but Tonya, you ain't finna come up here and talk about it. And then, depending on who it was, we ain't doing that. So it was like total, I don't know if you've been on my website, but I have this session on my website called Perfectly Rejected. Because that's all I felt all the time. But it, when I say perfectly, that means it all worked out for my good. Because I didn't need no people in my life. Right. So now how I handle people that are opposing my truth is I just live in it. Everybody's not my assignment. Everybody ain't got to like me. Everybody ain't got to be a part of truth. Everybody don't want. And I'm telling you, the saddest thing I think, like once you got truth and you still don't want to live authentic, that them the people I'd be like scared of, because I'm like, you mean to tell me you could be free and you don't want to? Truth is so free, even when it's not good. Even when it's not good, at least you know what you do. Because truth, when I die, be gone 2,000 years, whatever, truth is always going to be truth. Jesus been gone how long? Truth is still truth. It still stands. And so the freedom in that for I don't need nobody's validation. I don't need nobody's nothing, because it's my truth. So at this point, I don't handle it. I just go, if you can't handle me, there's, like I said, I don't know if I shared this before. There are people that want me to come speak on their programs. Oh, we need this, because who talks about sexual abuse and overcoming? And people, churches don't want that, so they block it. You mean to tell them you got all these people at your church, you don't want them free? You want to keep them in bondage? And so I don't, right now, I don't want to say I don't handle, I do pray for people, because life is, at its best, is hard and it's short, and you go through stuff, and somebody needs to be a voice. And if you go on my, anything with Tonya's Race, the voice of the voices, I'm going to sacrifice my life for it, because I believe you can't overcome. So when people don't want to impose my truth, I don't care if it's family, I don't care if it's friends, so-called, I don't care who you are. I just let you have, I still walk in my truth. There's nothing, you're not going to shut me up. This is my Facebook. You shut me up from your forum, but you can't shut up my Facebook. So I still speak out. This is how I handle it now. Because that's going to be, like, I mean, me and Robert was here. We were saying, saving one soul at a time. One soul at a time. This is my assignment. I don't need your validation, your permission, or nothing else. God has already granted me the ministry. Because if he didn't want me to do it, he wouldn't assign it to me. So right now, I don't handle when people are opposing me. I'll be like, okay. When I say I have lost people that I thought would be in my life forever. And they admit on the side. I know she's telling the truth, but we ain't finna deal with that. So you're letting your kids and your grandkids and your women of your congregation, even the men of your congregation, because men being abused too, you don't want them to get no freedom? Because it's not what we do at church? So I let them have their form. And I'm telling you what, even if you cut me off, this, and anybody that's been with me for a while, know, if you cut me off from your form and I think it's a good work, I'm still going to support it. I have been taken off a flyer before just because of truth. Oh, Tonya gonna come. And not because the person didn't want me there, the leadership or who the elders or whoever they got to deal with, the powers of be, and switch me off a flyer. I still show up because it's a good work. I just be consistent. I be Tonya. I walk in my truth. I don't need a form. I was not built to break. I don't need nothing to help somebody. So the people that's opposing the truth, there's always going to be somebody that don't. Jesus went through it. And he is truth. There's always going to be people, the naysayers or the people that, and the hardest thing for me is a lot of people don't even want healing. And when you're in a healing business and that's your product, for a better word, if that's your product and you like, okay, I did it, I overcome, I'm going to show you how to do it, and I'm going to tell you how I did it, and people don't want it, they rather suffer. That's hard for me to watch. So to me, that's an opposing of truth, because you don't want to, you rather protect your image, who you're attached to, and stuff like that, but you live in raggedy. Tonya goes to sleep at night. Tonya goes to sleep. Now, Tonya goes to sleep at night. Because when I wasn't walking my truth, when I was in that line and keeping secrets and stuff, it was too heavy. So now I have a peace that, and when it says a peace that passes all, I don't even understand it. And it's just to be preserved. I was out there. When I said I was homeless, y'all, I was homeless. I wasn't eating. And my dad had a whole bunch of food at home. But I'd rather be in them streets. That was my truth. Now my truth is God's using all that nasty and messy stuff for this. And so when you come to me and oppose it because you don't like it and that's not what we do at church. But all y'all broke in spirit. But you don't want no healing? So I just keep it moving. I God need me to do wherever he needs me to be and whatever he needs me to say, I walk in it. And so right now, at first I used to get hurt and call people back. Well, why you didn't want me to talk? Why? I mean, as an adult, I ain't talking about no child. As an adult, I have cried many tears because people didn't want me. I'm just trying to help. Shun me. I mean, if I walk in the building, on one side, they walking on the other side, and we supposed to be boys? What? Done all that. Done cried. Done shit. Done called people back. Oh, can we get together? Can we talk about it? I mean, I've done all this stuff because you're opposing truth. Don't you know this is going to help people? Trying to plead my case. That's what I used to do. Now I just walk in my truth. And whoever wants to hear truth, they're welcome to hear my truth. I don't fight. I don't fuss. I don't try to make people stay that want to walk away. I don't do none of that no more. So that's how I handle it now. Okay, how do my siblings treat me about my truth? That is a very good question. Over time, well, at first it was hard. At first it was hard because they came up with me. Whatever goes on, you just keep it in the house. But Tonya, you okay, right? So then, but don't mean everybody gonna be like you and they're gonna go through these changes. So it was a lot of that. And then that goes back to the loyalty. Like, even if you agree with me, but if church is this way, you're gonna be loyal to that. You're gonna be loyal to your parent. You're gonna be loyal to whatever that society is, that organization is. So a lot of times I got fussed out, and I ain't gonna lie, I got fussed out about both of my siblings because of some of the stuff I was sharing. Because it all goes back to an image. But now, on a lot of things, we agree. They just don't show up in them like it does, and they are not as open as I am about it. But we don't fall out about it. And right now, if when I do stuff that, you know, before Corona, there are times they support and there are times they're not. It depends on what was going on, to be honest. I was hurt a lot because they wouldn't come support. But for my brother, he lives way in Texas, so he can't come a lot. But I think in their way, I know that they know I'm walking in what God has me to do. So, and they don't discourage me. But it's not a lot of rah, rah, rah either. I ain't got no pom-poms or no chilliness or nothing like that. But I think in their way, because they just love me. I never say just because you don't support a particular thing that you don't love me. But I think in their way, as we keep growing, like I said, I'm 51. Sister's going to be 49. My brother's 47. At this stage of life, we know we probably lived a little longer than we're going to live. And it's time for us to kind of, we've had these conversations about, regardless of what we disagree about, that we got to, enjoy each other while we have time. But there are times when they do support and then there are times they're not. And they were, before as treat me about the truth, they were rejected at sometimes because it made certain things look bad for the family or the church. So they didn't want to deal with that. So that's my honest, transparent answer. We didn't see eye to eye a lot on those kind of things, on how I was, my method of healing or my method of truth. That was uncomfortable for them as well. You see? Okay. I have another comment. It said, healing comes from the truth being exposed. Totally agree. I'm telling you, I'm such a better Tonya now because people be tripping out on me because I was sharing the story. People have actually approached me and say, did you sleep with my husband? Right? Because they found out through, and it might be years later, right? And I'm in a better place now. I ain't that girl no more, but they came up to me. And I'd be like, yeah? What you mean? You gonna tell me the truth? You ask me? But this, let me tell you where I was. And I'm just always that person now where when you walk in truth, you have to deal with all the truth that even if the stuff you don't like. And when I tell you guys, me not having so many secrets or me walking in my truth is such a healthy way of living. Even when I struggle now, my husband's sitting right here. Do I talk straight and tell you the truth? Straight on raw. Raw, because I don't feel like me making something up or trying to find these choice words or not calling it what it is, that ain't going to help me live. I'm not going to be able to change it. I'm never going to be able to fix it. So, truth, and I just want, when I talk about secrets and lies and stuff, live in your truth. I don't mean, and I'm tell y'all something about even when stuff is exposed. And I'm tell you what I was guilty of. There are days I wanted to be, so I was so mad. I'm like, I'm finna shut all this down. I'm going to walk up in the church. I'm going to tell everybody. That ain't God. There are things that can be exposed in a right way. And what I'm saying, because you don't want to have collateral damage, right? There are some people that are just totally innocent. So I've learned, even because when y'all talking about anger, angry and bitter, that, boy, I might as well have the billboard. Me, that was me. I'm living like this, and y'all living like this, and y'all acting like y'all ain't did nothing, and everybody got to clap when you come in the room. When I come in the room, everybody looking at me like I'm crazy. Oh, we finna shut all of this down. I've been there. But I was like, something in me was like, what, God got this. God got this. And there are some things that have been able to mend. Like I said, we ain't boys. There are some relationships that have been able to mend where the wife didn't have to get hurt. And then the children didn't get to get hurt. Then the grandchildren got to get hurt. You know what I'm saying? So there's a way to, even in exposure, there's a way to do that. And so, but I do believe in need to expose some. And y'all know how I feel about children. Protect your children. Protect your children. Do not come to me. I got somebody now. I'm telling you now, don't come to me with it. Your husband molested your child? There ain't no choice for me. Protect your child. Don't think you're going to have a relationship with Tonya and I'm not going to tell you the truth about what you need to do. Don't come with me with that. Because I'm going to take care of the child. Protect your children, people. Please protect your children. A lot of the stuff that they're dealing with ain't just because they crazy. Ain't nobody just happen to get crazy. Investigate. All right, you guys. I think I done went, overboard. I hope this conversation, like I said, I'm not mad at people. I'm just excited. And I'm passionate about this particular subject because I seen how it affected me in my life. So I'm going to ask my husband to come pray. But before he does that, I want y'all to pray for Apostle Samuel. She was on here last week, and she's under the weather. Pray for my mother-in-law, Irma Smith. She had surgery today. Pray for my cousin, Kevin Gibbs. He's also recovering. And pray for everyone who's depressed and, you know, and suicidal because of COVID. This thing is very serious. It's not, like I said last week, it's not just affecting, 2 weeks ago, it's just not affecting the physical body, it's affecting the mind. So we're not dealing, you know, this secret thing is this on pandemic. So just pray for me, because definitely pray for me. Keep me in your prayer, because like I said, this is a heavy mandate. There are some people that's probably mad tonight, and it's going to be something, but Tonya's good. I can handle it, but I do not ever, my truth is not to hurt people. My ministry is not to hurt people. My whole, if you know about me, I'm all about mending broken lives. That's all I'm about, healing. And the time that we do have left, let's live it faithfully, honestly, and with integrity, honestly, completely. Okay. And so, please just pray for me. Pray for my business, Tonya's Embrace. And I am here. Yes, I am a life coach. If you need help, you need the tools to help me walk you through your journey, I can do that with you. My email is tonyasembrace@yahoo.com. My is LaTonyaSmith.com. Please reach out to me. If you're on Facebook, you can inbox me. If you, my phone number is 919-423-1505. You can contact me anyway. I just want you to get the help that you need so you can go forward in life, which is what I want to do, let you know that you can overcome. So I hope this has been a healthy conversation, and think about the secrets in your life. We didn't deal with a lot with confronting the family secret, but if y'all want to talk about that, let me know. Then I can make that like a part two of how do you confront when it's a family secret, and how do you do that? I've had to do that. So this, if that's what you want to talk about, part two, let me know. We can do that, because it's all about healing people. It's all about truth. It's all about living forward, going forward, and living the best life you can live. Like I said, pray for me, pray for my health, and that I be obedient and take these pills and medication that I'm supposed to be taking, so that I can get better. So this pray. I won't be hard-headed, because I'm stubborn. But I want to feel good, so I better take this medicine. So just pray for me. Pray for, a lot of things are coming up for me by the grace of God. And it's amazing how people try to shut doors, and God himself will open the door, whether they shut it or not. And so just pray that I will be a good steward over all the stuff that he's having me to do. And that I just be good and take care of the gift, you know, that I'm supposed to do. Just that I be just a good person, because I'm a human being. There's some struggles that I have, period, that I have to work on daily as well. So just pray for my business. I believe God, if he gives you the vision, he'll give you the provision. He's the source, and resources will come even in the time of a pandemic. Pray that if I get a job, just pray for whatever God has in store for me, that I will take care of it and walk in his truth and walk in his way. And that I just keep being a voice, just being a voice for him. So my husband's going to come now. I'll see you guys. Part two, and also please send me your email addresses, people. There are some things I have going, so I need your email addresses. So you can just put it in Transparent Thursdays, you can put it on my regular one, I don't care, but I need everybody's email address. Thank you so much. Y'all have a great evening.
We thank everybody for joining in tonight. If you put in the comments, if you've been blessed tonight, been helped tonight, put in the comment, I've been blessed and I've been helped. Let us pray. Most Holy and Everlasting Father, we come this Thursday night to say, first of all, thank you for your many blessings you have bestowed upon us. We thank you, God, for this wonderful teaching tonight by my wife. We thank you, God, that you're able to look beyond all of our faults and see every one of our needs.
Yes, sir.
And God, we ask you that you are blessed tonight, God, yes, those God. Who are struggling with many different areas of their life, struggling with lies and secrets, that they will come clean and live in their truth. God, you got the power to do anything but fail. So God, we ask you right now to heal their minds, heal their soul, heal their spirit. Their soul's been damaged, but God, you can restore, you can renew, you can give them refresh. You can refresh them even right now. So continue to bless this ministry, God, Transparent Thursday, each and every day. God, continue to bless those who are online, those who are dealing with many different issues and struggles and many different trials and tribulations. But God, you can lift up their souls and their spirit. And those who are sick tonight, God, you are a healer.
Yes.
We actually will continue to touch Apostle Samuel in a special way. Continue to bless my mother in a special way, my cousin. And bless those who are sick even right now. I don't know their name, but God, you know them far and near. Touch them right now. For God, you are a healer. And these blessings, we ask that you continue the spirit, that you would let your spirit overflow. Let your spirit get in our spirits and let us be a new creature. Oh God, you are an awesome God. You are a deliverer. You are come in right now and touch those who need your blessings, those who need your spirit, touch them right now. And for that, God, we give you glory. We give you praise in Jesus' mighty name. And everybody say amen.
Amen. Good night, everyone. See you next week.
Good night. Be blessed.